News this noon, shockwaves in the Florida legislature. Jennifer Carroll has resigned as the lieutenant governor of Florida. I'm Jason Guy.
And I'm Meredith McDonough. Carroll stepped down in the wake of a federal investigation of internet cafes. Carroll consulted for a group called the Allied Veterans of the World when she was in the Florida House.
And right now, several local internet cafes associated with that group are being raided by investigators. The allegations include racketeering charges associated with illegal gambling software. Raids are taking place in Marion, Brevard, and Volusia counties. WESH 2's Dave McDaniel joins us right now with the allegations and the fallout. Dave?
Well, first of all, Jason, the lieutenant governor's resignation letter is brief. It says, effective immediately, I hereby resign the office of lieutenant governor of the state of Florida. It has been an honor to have served the state of Florida in this capacity. With that, she's out. And at a news conference this afternoon, we'll hear much more about the case, which we first learned of late yesterday.
Longwood cops shut down the Allied Veterans location in 2009, saying it was illegal gambling. Allied fought back, saying it was a legal sweepstakes with a predetermined outcome and not a game of chance. The arrest Tuesday painted a different picture. Investigators are alleging racketeering and money laundering, and that the games, which look exactly like online slot machines, and the accusation is that it is illegal gaming. 51 total Florida locations were searched as part of this investigation into Allied Veterans Management and Allied Veterans of the World. Leaders of the organization have reportedly been arrested, including two leaders of the Fraternal Order of Police in Jacksonville. They should go before a Seminole County judge this afternoon. According to the IRS, the fundraising centers were nothing more than internet casinos, which operated slot machines in violation of Florida's gambling laws, and that Allied Veterans represented that they donated anywhere from 70% of all of the net proceeds. However, only 2%, $6 million of the $290 million in proceeds, was donated. The lieutenant governor's ties to the group were questioned when she was still in the legislature after she reportedly proposed a bill which would benefit internet cafes.
Now, the Florida Democratic Party has also released a statement regarding the resignation of Jennifer Carroll. It reads in part, Floridians expected an administration focused on solving the problems facing Florida's families, but instead got a scandal-plagued governor and a revolving staff door. Now, again, a news conference is set for this afternoon in Orlando at FDLE headquarters. We should know a lot more about the level of this alleged fraud at that time. Jason, Meredith.